This is a magnificent day for our campus, a fabulous way to inaugurate the academic year.
Reinventing STEM education is an ambitious enough goal by itself. But beyond that goal, we have an even bigger ambition: to unleash the passion and drive of our students so that they can develop innovative solutions that truly match the needs of people and communities.
We've been teaching interdisciplinary design classes, and over the years, the student interest in those types of classes has just exploded to the point where we've had to turn many students away because the classes were oversubscribed. And Jacobs Hall gives us the space to scale this model of instruction to hundreds of students a semester.
This place is so inviting. When the students fill it up, there'll be, I imagine, a lot of collaboration, a lot of exchanging of ideas. It just seems a very creative space. It doesn't look like a normal classroom. It's not going to be used like a normal classroom either. So I have high hopes for the projects that come out of here.
For me, I think the space would be like almost a bird's nest, so that a variety of students, innovators from across disciplines, from art, from engineering, from architecture, even people from psychology and cognitive science can all come together and collaborate.
I am so excited for the classes, projects, conversations that are going to take place in this building behind me.
The Jacobs Institute creates the environment where visions can become reality, and I'm very much proud to be part of that.
Educating leaders, creating knowledge, serving society. That's Berkeley, that's engineering, that's Jacob Hall, and the Jacobs Institute. And it's going to be fantastic.
One of my favorite sayings is that the best way to predict the future is to invent it. And I have a prediction. A lot of our future is going to be invented here.